Formic is my favorite form library. It takes away the complexity of creating good forms. No longer do you have to worry about form fields, whether they've been touched, are they valid, should they be required, what error messages should I show on screen, and a whole bunch more. So in this video, we're going to be looking at how to implement Formic in your next project. So we're going to start this project off with a Next.js application. You can use Formic with any kind of React-based framework, so Next.js, Gatsby, Redwood. You can also use it with React Native if you're into mobile development. So now we have our Next.js application. The next thing we need to do is install Formic so that we can start using it. So within our terminal, you can do yarn add Formic. And then once that's installed, we can start talking about how you implement forms using it. So now the package is installed, we're going to start building out a form. Now we're going to use very basic implementation of Formic and it handles a lot more, but I just want to introduce you to this form library so you can check it out for your next project. So we'll delete all of the code except from the main section, which we'll keep for ourselves, and we'll delete everything inside of the main. And we'll change this to welcome to Formic implementation. So now we have the Formic implementation ready to go. We need to start using Formic to create our forms. So we need to import Formic at the top. So we're going to import Formic. That's going to come from Formic. And now we're actually ready to create forms. What's really cool about Formic is it allows you to use two different options for creating forms. Fully customized, which allows you to use whatever kind of library frameworks you want to use, whatever validation you want to use, a whole bunch of stuff like that, and you can manually do all of the work. The second option is to use the built-in components that allow you to drive your forms. So you can use things like form and fields and things like that to drive your forms, allowing you to not have to worry so much about how to implement on changes and on blurs and on validation and all that stuff, and just worry about what fields I need and how they're going to be handled in certain scenarios. So let's go and use those to create our form. So in our application here, we have Formic installed, but we're also going to install form and we're also going to install field. And these two things together can essentially drive your whole form together. So inside of our application here, the first thing we want to do is to create our initial values that when someone lands on the page, let's say that this is going to be a form submission for a contact form. We want them to have the initial values of nothing or empty strings so we can handle it later on. So underneath our main here and underneath our title, we can use the Formic here. And then it has props that we can use. So we're going to use the initial values prop. So initial values equals, and this is basically an object where you can put all of the pieces for your form. So for a contact form, we're going to need name, we're going to need email, and we're going to need the message that they want to write. So all three of those together will create our form. So inside of this initial values, we can write name, and we'll set that to empty string. We'll say email, we'll name to empty string, and finally message. And we'll set that to an empty string as well. So now we have initial values. The other part is on submission. Obviously, we're not going to submit this form, although if you are interested in watching a video on creating a contact form, I'll drop a card at the top where you can learn about making a Airtabled powered contact form. So now we need to do on submit. So for now, for on submit, we'll just do a function here and it will be asynchronous because it's probably going to be asynchronous in general. And we'll do some values, which are going to be passed by Formic to this on submit. So all the values that you include in the initial values have to be there. So if your form has a dozen values, they all have to be there for Formic to be able to track them as people are using them. And then when you do on submission, it has those values and it will pass them along so that you can send it to your API or send it to a database or send it wherever you need to go. So from here, we're just going to say an arrow, and then inside of there, we'll do alert json.stringify, and then values. And then we'll do null too. Save. And now we have the ability to essentially track these as needed. So now we have an onSubmit and we have the form itself. So we can actually now close this out. And now we can wrap our form in this. So what we can do now is a form with a capital F, and that will be the formic form. So this has its own form that we're closing out here. And inside of this form, we just put our fields. So I'll do a label here and we'll fill that out in a second. And then underneath that, we can use field and then the field ID. And these IDs here need to match the value that you have in your initial values so that it knows which one to be tracking at the time. So we'll put name in here. And then we'll give it a name also of name. And then we can give it a placeholder. So placeholder, we'll say Bruce Wayne. And then we can close this field out. Now we have this field, we'll just have to do the others. So we'll do another label, which we'll fill out in a second. We'll do another field here and we'll say email, name equals email, placeholder equals batman@gmail.com. And then finally, we need our message. So we'll do one more label here, which we'll fill out. And we'll just do a field. We'll do message as the ID. We'll give it a name as well of ID of message. And a placeholder. Please save Gotham. Okay. So now we have all of our fields and we have our labels. So let me just fill these labels out really quickly and I'll speed up so that you don't have to watch me. If you've never used an HTML label before, it essentially puts something on screen so somebody knows what they're supposed to be entering. It's good accessibility product and you should do it on every single form that you have. So now we have the form and it is essentially ready to go at this point and we can test this out and then we'll add some additional validation and some features that you can use with Formic. So let's go ahead and run our code here and see what it does. So as you can see, we just have a very basic implementation of a horrible looking form here. And as we type in each of these, we can essentially do whatever we want. Hello there. But we may want to actually submit this and do some other stuff. So let's add some additional features. Right now we have a good looking form, but we need to add things like validations on submits, a button to submit. Maybe we need to check to make sure that's an actual email and a few other things. So let's go back to our code and make some additional changes. So inside of our code, first thing we can do is actually set this to type and set it to email. Just so we have that HTML email. So now we have that, we need to do some sort of validation. So we can go ahead and handle validation as well. So validation can be done at the field level. So essentially you can add a validation here that says it must follow some sort of schema. Maybe their first and last name together has to equate 10 characters. It needs to be an email address, which is required. The message must be more than 2 characters, for example. All those kinds of things can be handled here. So what we can do is add some validation here. So what I'll do is in our email and underneath our placeholder here, I'll write validate equals and we'll do email validation. We don't have this function yet, but let's go ahead and write it. So then up here, we can create a const called email validation. And this is going to take a value and that value is going to be the value from the form. This function is essentially going to check to make sure that it has a field and it's also an email address, which you can use regex for. So let's go ahead and do that. So we can say let error if there is no value. So if the value is essentially empty, error equals required. And then underneath our error there for no value, we can do else if. And then inside that else if, we can do error equals invalid email address. And then finally return error. And then we just need to do the else if here. What I'll do for the else if is I'm just going to copy and paste the regex for an email to save us writing the very complicated piece of code that goes along with it. So now that we've finished our validation, we now need to go down into our formic here and just make a quick change. And all we're going to do here is underneath our formic, but before our form, we're going to pass along errors touched and is validating. And those are all things that are available in formic. And then from there, we can pass along. And we can take these two here and drop them underneath our form, like so. And now we have access to these. We can actually use them wherever we want. So what we need to do now is just add a div underneath here that says errors.email and touched.email. And touched just essentially is saying, I have been in this and then I've left. And then we can say div. And inside of here, we can do errors.email and hit save. So now what should happen is if this is incorrect and this error returns something up here, this will show up for the user. So we have our form here. It's not great and styled very well, but it's a functional form. So if I type in here, James, and I go to this next one, and maybe I just type in hello and hit tab, you'll see immediately invalid email address has appeared. We can also delete that out and hit tab, and now you'll see required is there. So let's refresh the page and try James, skip the email and try testing and hit submit form. And as you can see, required has appeared again for this email because you're required to have this before you can even hit the submit button. So it gives you the variety of being able to essentially validate what is in your field beforehand so that you're not even attempting the submission. So really hope you enjoyed this basic look at Formic and how it can help you with forms in the future. If you're interested in learning how to add authentication to your application in 5 minutes, go ahead and click this video right here. It will show you how to add Clerk to a Next.js app in under 5 minutes.